Hi everyone, my name is Michelle. In today's episode, I'm going straight into curve, depth, brush option under brush menu. At the end of the tutorial, what I'm trying to achieve is this result, where the belt is sitting on top of the skin and totally not embedded. I think this is suitable not only for belt models, but for 3D printed items that you can wear like armor or mask. Let's start. Over here, I have Julie's torso as a poly mesh 3D. Control, right click, move right to zoom in. Hide 3 strips of left-right poly loop with the bottom strip as a frame for a curved line. Control, shift, tap on an edge for each poly loop. Then Control, shift, tap on a polygon to invert the visibility. This way we can look from the top or bottom to check on the thickness and depth of the belt later on. In order to view the inner surface, let's turn on double from display properties. Now, using curve strap snap, click from the center of the visible strips, drag towards the bottom edge. When the cursor is at the edge of the strip, press and hold shift. When a curved line appears, you can let go of your stylus and shift. A strap will appear in place of the curved line. Please check out my previous tutorial on how to use and edit curve strap snap. When I let go of the stylus, the torso will also be masked. This way, I will not be able to edit the torso accidentally. From this view, we can see that the belt is quite thick, and it is embedded into the skin as well as extrude out of the surface of the skin. I want the back edge of the belt to butt against the skin surface as close as possible. In order to achieve that, go under brush, then depth tap. There is an image with a black dot and a white circle with a line running across the center. The top of the circle is the highest point of the strap. The bottom of the circle, the lowest point. The black dot, the center position. The black line, the surface of the skin. To demonstrate the effects of this black dot and white circle, let me increase the thickness of the belt, which means the Z intensity, to 50. Lightly tap on the belt. Lightly, so that I don't accidentally move it. Now, the thickness is equally distributed inside and outside of the skin surface. Let's use the depth tap to pull the belt out of the skin. Sounds dramatic. Increase the embed by clicking and dragging upwards on the white circle or black dot. Once again, lightly tap on the red curve line to update the strap. See how it is raised above the skin surface? Just like the image on the depth tap. If you rotate the model around, you can see the belt is floating on top of the skin because the embed is at the maximum 100 points. Let's lower depth so that it is closer to the skin surface. About 70 points. Basically, you can keep adjusting the depth by raising or lowering the embed value to the desired depth. Let me just speed up this whole adjustment process where I eventually ended up with embed value of 90 points. Another thing to note is that curve line remains editable until you use another brush or action to modify your model. For example, I use the select lasso brush to hide another strip. Then go back to click on the curve line. Curve strap snap will generate another new strap on top of the existing strap. The previous belt is merged as part of the torso subtool with a different polygroup color. So overall, there is only one subtool but 3 different polygroup colors. Let me Ctrl Z to undo all this. Another way to keep them separate is to split them out as separate subtools so that I can turn them on or off when I'm not sure which look I'm going for. Go under Subtool, Split, and Split Unmasked or Split Masked. The only difference I found with these two are whichever option you clicked on. For example, I clicked on Unmasked Points, that polygroup subtool will be below the original subtool. If you have transparency turned on like I do, Whichever subtool is not active will be see-through. This way, we can analyze the effects of different versions of belt better. Even though I'm using brush depth on curve line in this tutorial, brush depth also applies for other brushes without curve lines, such as insert multi-mesh, B, I, and you can select from the different brushes available. The only difference is that there is no red line to tap for updates, but needs to be redrawn in order to reflect the changes. Let me draw an eyelid as an example. The brush depth is at 0. I need to remove subdivision levels to be able to use IMM brush. Click and drag down to apply it on a surface. Let's view from the side. Let's lower the depth by changing the embed value to 38. And then press Ctrl Z to undo and redraw the eyelid again with the new embed value. If you want, you can still change it into a curve line by going under stroke, then curve to turn on curve mode. This way we can update it by tapping on a curve line like what we have done previously. This is still a curve line with an embed value of negative 38. Let's change it to negative 18. Then lightly tap on a curve line again to update. There are still many more brushes which will respond to this brush depth option. Just go to BI, select any IMM brushes to explore. There are at least 20 of them here. It definitely did take me some time to explore, but just remember that if it is not a curve line, it needs to be redrawn to reflect the updates. And with that, let me just end my tutorial here and enjoy exploring. In the next tutorial, I'm going to use the belt I made to extrude out a plane so that I can have some fun with dynamics. If all is well, I'll see you in the next tutorial. Stay away from Omicron!